Hi there. This video will show you how to design on a shoulder and neck rigid box Dieline template. While adding your design to the Dieline template, it can be helpful to refer back to the shoulder and neck rigid box orientation guide to see how you should place your design elements. To show you how to add your design to a shoulder and neck rigid box Dieline template, let's use this PackMojo box as a base and add some additional elements. As you can see, this box has a different color on the neck, as well as the interior of the base, finished with some logo and text elements on several panels. Shoulder and neck rigid boxes are made using pieces of grayboard and substrate materials that are glued to the board. It is composed of one lid and two trays, a neck tray and base tray, that are glued together. When adding your designs to the Dieline template, make sure not to add your designs to the main board. Instead, shoulder and neck rigid boxes are made using 5 sheets of substrate that you will need to add your designs to. By referencing the orientation guide, we can see that there is one substrate for the exterior of the lid, one for the interior of the lid, one for the exterior of the neck tray, one for the interior of the neck tray, and one for the exterior of the base tray. Since the neck tray and base tray are glued together, we will not need a design for the interior of the base tray as it will not be visible. Let's begin by designing the exterior of the lid. When adding your designs, please remember to account for bleeds, meaning artwork at the edge should extend beyond the die line. The top of the lid and the lid side closest to you when opening the box will maintain the same orientation. For designs on the left side of the lid exterior, designs will need to be rotated 90 degrees clockwise. For designs on the right side of the lid exterior, designs will need to be rotated 90 degrees anti-clockwise. For designs on the last lid side, which is shown here above the lid top, designs will need to be inverted. In order to achieve a smooth and clean look for the box exterior, there will be a portion of the exterior substrate that will be wrapped around the edges onto the inside of the lid, making it visible from the interior. The interior of the lid will be quite similar, with designs on the lid inside and lid side closest in the same orientation. Designs on the left interior rotated 90 degrees clockwise. Designs on the right interior rotated 90 degrees anti-clockwise, and designs on the last lid side inverted. For the exterior of the base tray, designs on the base bottom and the base side above the bottom, which should be the side further from you, will maintain the same orientation. Inverse from the lid, designs on the base tray's left side will need to be rotated 90 degrees anti-clockwise, whereas designs on the base tray's right side will need to be rotated 90 degrees clockwise. Finally, designs on the last side, shown here below the base bottom, will need to be inverted. Similar to the box lid, in order to achieve a smooth and clean look for the base exterior, there will be a portion of the exterior substrate that will be wrapped around the edges onto the inside of the base, and thus will not be visible when looking at the exterior. Since the neck tray is glued securely in the base tray, we will not need to add designs for the interior of the base tray, as it will not be visible. For the exterior of the neck tray, layouts are quite similar to the base tray. However, we will not have to worry about adding designs to the base, as it will be glued securely to the interior of the base tray. Designs on the tray side will also be partly cut off depending on the exact dimensions of your box. This is because they will be hidden behind the side walls of your base tray when glued together. Thus, we generally recommend a solid color or pattern throughout. Similarly, in order to achieve a smooth and clean look for the base exterior, there will be a portion of the exterior substrate that will be wrapped around the edges onto the inside of the base, and thus will not be visible when looking at the exterior. For the interior of the neck tray, designs on the base inside, and the base side above the base inside, designs will stay in the same orientation. Similar to the neck tray exterior, designs on the left side will need to be rotated 90 degrees anti-clockwise, whereas designs on the right side will need to be rotated 90 degrees clockwise. Designs on the remaining side, shown below the base inside, will need to be inverted. When you're done designing, double-check it with the Dieline orientation guide to make sure that everything is in the correct location and orientation. To learn more about adding logos, vectorizing text, or embedding images, click on the link in the description or head to our website for more design tips. Happy designing!